As COVID-19 continues to be a part of our lives, there's another growing health concern, monkeypox. So far, Baltimore's reported at least 5 cases of the virus. The city's health commissioner is working with the state to administer vaccinations. But just what is it and how's it spread? We're joined now by Dr. Kinjal Sheth from Northwest Baltimore. Dr. Sheth, thank you for joining us. I'm happy we were able to pull you away, so we'll get you back to vacation. But this is pretty serious back here at home. When it comes to monkeypox, because I feel right now, a lot of folks just don't know what we're dealing with. So give us the Cliff Notes version. What is this all about when it comes to monkeypox?
First and foremost, I think in general, there's just been kind of a fatigue because obviously we're still getting through COVID. But when it comes to monkeypox, it's a similar version to chickenpox, but it's actually a milder version. So you're going to get your rash, fevers, those types of things. And the main way that people contract it is through skin-to-skin contact. So if you notice anybody with any of those symptoms, you want to avoid sharing clothes, linens, and any type of close contact with them.
One bit of curiosity that I do have is that as the initial reports have come out, there was a sort of connecting it with HIV. They were saying that maybe gay men and sex was the main concern that they're looking for. But I'm guessing that everyone should be on alert, correct?
For whatever reason, there has been a higher prevalence in gay men, but overall, this can affect anybody.
Tell me a little bit about vaccinations. What we know so far about the vaccination that's out right now, and how should I be communicating with my doctor about it?
There is a vaccination that does work. We just have limited supply. The CDC is increasing production, and we're going to be getting it, especially in the state of Maryland, pretty soon as the cases have been rising. But in general, if you haven't been in contact with anybody who's had it, then there shouldn't be, you know, an over concern for it of getting that vaccination right away.
I feel like that we've seen some things online where some people are talking about having communications with their doctor and then being sent to the CDC and then back to their doctor again, because I think everyone is sort of learning on the fly right now. Is that the sense you're getting, at least here in the United States, that we're still all learning together?
It's one of these things where, you know, we've always known about it. We just haven't had that many cases. And this is a kind of a small outbreak of it. And so we just don't want it to become one of those things where it continues to spread over and over.
So, Doc, one more time, I'll get you to walk me through. If you have concerns, if you've developed a rash or you think that you've had symptoms that you've seen on television, what should you be doing right now when it comes to monkeypox?
You do want to isolate yourself for 24 to 48 hours in terms of, you know, you don't want to be close contact with anybody. When I talk about close contact, it's not about the respiratory symptoms. It's skin to skin contact. So you don't want to be sharing the same sheets, same towels, those types of things. You don't want any your skin touching somebody else. So that way that they don't really get the disease as well. That's the biggest thing.
All right. That's Dr. Kinjal Sheth. Thank you for the time, sir. And thank you for making the time during vacation. We appreciate it.
Anytime. Anything for you, Jason.
Take care.